Hey guys, welcome back to He Works Hard for the Honey. You can see I'm here at the second hive, doing largely the same thing. We're going to be breaking it down, checking to see if we need to put some more nectar on here, which I've been doing lately to sort of encourage their growing. And we've got some earwigs in here, which we want to get them out. We want nothing but bees in here. Yeah. Just like the other hive, it looks like these guys have massacred the outside food that I'm putting in there, which hopefully means that they've sort of expanded better. Oh yeah, these guys are in need of a new bottle. I'm gonna put them over here for now. Let them figure their own way off of there. A little smoke to help. And as has generally been the case, these guys have been the more active bees as far as expanding. I'm seeing a lot of activity up in the second box here, which hopefully is going to translate. Into being ready for some honey supers. A lot of you guys have been asking, both on the website, through text message, about honey. Can't make any promises just yet till we start filling some honey supers. But if you're interested, we'd love to hear from you so we can start planning. And I hope we'll be able to fill the demand. I have read that a regular hive like this will produce 100 to 200 pounds of honey in a season. These guys had to really establish themselves where we're not going to produce anywhere near that. But when you think about that, you'd think, let's say 100 pounds each hive for two hives, and there is some potential that both of these hives will be ready to split either before the fall or after the winter, kind of depending on how healthy they get, how quickly. Here we go with this internal roof. Oh yeah, a lot of activity there. It's great. Put these guys, let them find their own way in. And I seem to do this every week, and I wonder why. They're not spaced very well in here, which can lead to some sloppy building. On the bees part, let's see if I can now it's maybe not the best idea to have a black t-shirt on. Bees will kind of see dark browns and blacks, and it just kind of makes you look more like a predator. It makes me look like more like a North American black bear, and more likely to be stung. I never claimed to be too bright, though. Alright, we got a frame out here that's completely empty. No wax. Well, we got wax on this side. I take back what I said. And again, a little bit of wax, a little bit on this side. They're making their way in, and then, wow, next I see some full frames. So, they are expanding, and we're gonna wanna continue to put some syrup in the feeders and getting it to these ladies. Oh, this is a heavy one. There is a decent bit of very deep honey. Maybe up the top here, it's built a little. See some capped brood. Well, I don't think I see eggs, but I see some very, very young larvae, which is good. Oh, no, I do see eggs. We're good here. We are good. And the same on this side. We've got a lot of resources. A lot of very colorful pollen. And again, I love when it happens. We've got a bee chewing out and being born right here at the end of my finger. Once again, she's right there at the end of my finger. Welcome to the hive, little lady. And she is fully out. Hoorah! Welcome to the fold. All right, it's been a good sign so far that there are no queen cups. At least in this upper box so far, no signs that these ladies are getting ready to swarm. So we're getting to these middle frames. you know, just like in the lower boxes, this is going to be where the lion's share of the brood is going to be. And the resources go more towards the outside, and that's just because of the internal temperature they can keep it. And just like the bottom, we've got some capped honey, we've got a lot of larvae. I can see some bees just starting to chew through, so we're having a lot of birth, just like we did 2 weeks ago. Is exciting. The hive continues to expand. I imagine we're going to see a great deal more of that in the lower box that they had already had established when I brought them back